selling the power of a renewable future.
Have you got solar on the roof? Or
we haven't. We need that.
As his government works on rebuilding the foundations of the energy system after the historic move by the Australian energy market operator to suspend the spot market to avoid winter blackouts.
But I also said that they would stay in place for not a day longer or a day shorter than the chief executive of AEMO judged as necessary.
Now, 7 days since the hold was imposed, supply has come surging back.
That means the risk of any shortfall has reduced markedly,
prompting hopes of a staged return to normal operations. From 4am tomorrow, AEMO will allow the market to set the price again, but under supervision and with price caps. At least 24 hours later, provided power has been guaranteed, it'll formally relinquish its suspension.
This step-by-step approach minimises the risk of seeing the dysfunctional behaviour that led to the market suspension last week.
But with soaring global coal and gas prices and ageing power stations, the Energy Minister warns the country isn't out of the woods just yet.
This is a massive transformation which we need to get cracking on. We need to make faster progress on this transformation of the energy grid, and we need the capacity mechanism to help us do that.
With Australia's energy crisis averted for now, the Prime Minister pledging to prioritise green energy and again slamming the former government for its lack of investment in renewables.
We've had a decade of denial and delay. You can't fix that in 10 days. Seriously, these people need to have a look in the mirror, have a think about their failure and what they did.
We had the right rate of transition in place. It's Labor that talks up the acceleration to renewables. At the heart of this problem is not understanding that a transition takes time and a transition uses gas.
The transition back to the spot market now mapped out, but longer-term problems with the system yet to be resolved. Shubha Krishnan, SBS World News.